thought that I would be doing something useful to the society, but that never materialized. And it was only due to one of my respected, as a respected person, a friend did a Vipassana course once upon a time. And then he told me that this might be good for you. I did that course. And I really felt that I had learned something. I got something from it. Then the person suggested, why don't you come and volunteer? So that was my first big entry into that field. It was 4.5 years, 5 years back. So at that time, I was pretty new to that thing. And so as I have volunteered, I thought how many there were many places where I had volunteered. 8 of those places where I have volunteered for more than 5 days. So I took a cutoff. Like when I say people, I said I have volunteered at more than 8 places, but only in 8 places for more than 5 days. Because there has to be some cutoff. You go somewhere and you probably do something for 1 hour. Does that count as volunteering? Do you get from that experience? And do you really make a difference? These are all questions that come out when you go out and when you do something. But I find that a lot of people are not willing to devote even 1 hour of their time towards anything. They have a lot of excuses and misconceptions. So to clear those, I made this small slide deck. Myth one, you volunteer to help others. Actually, you are not. You are volunteering to help yourself. If you really feel that there is a problem out there that needs to be solved, you go out there and solve it, if it's nagging you so much. And yes, in the process, you will help others. But if you are thinking, I'm volunteering, it would help others, no, it's probably something like entitlement that you have. If I am volunteering and making a product, that's because I am somehow increasing my compassion or whatever to that level that I am actually useful to other people. So I think volunteering is a journey inwards, not a journey outwards. Second myth, you will be all alone. So am I the only lunatic around here who goes out there and help, you know, do this, does this stuff and volunteers for different organizations? As I went on and went to different places, I discovered there are more lunatics like me. And there are people, there are honest people, there are people full with compassion and with determination who are working for those causes. And that vindication, that validation, social proof keeps you on. But you have to get started. You will not find those people in your social circles, whatever you are currently hanging out with. Otherwise, you would already be doing all sorts of stuff. Myth three, you need a big fire or cause to drive you. It doesn't work that way. I mean, probably you are driven by something and you are powerless to do anything about it. For example, let's say you are driven by, let's say you faced a situation where you had to pay a bribe forcibly and you are very driven about anti-corruption. But can you really do anything on your own? Probably you need a group of people and you need to go out. But that's a case coming from where you have a big fire and you are trying to do something about it. Most of the cases, it is not like that. Most of my opportunities have been through friends and people whom I respect. They said, why don't you come out and help out here? For example, sir was talking about bar camp, organizing this bar camp. Why don't you come and volunteer at bar camp? So these small opportunities actually lead to, you know, bigger opportunities later on. You have to get started somewhere. You don't need to be so driven by your cause. Just, you know, just think of how to use your skills for a particular cause or a particular movement that is already occurring. Myth four, it takes a large miracle or force to actually change the world. There is an environmentalist called Claude Alvarez who works anti-mining in Goa. He had a very nice thing to share with us. So what he shared is, it only takes to win a single PIL, public interest litigation. And that would be held as a precedent, and that will be the standard under which all future cases will be evaluated to. So this guy won a single mining case against Vedanta in Goa, and that was cited as a precedent all across high courts of India. And he said it costed me only 250, even less than 250. Right now the 250 rupees it takes to file a PIL and 10 rupees to file a RTI. It was far lesser than that. And the lawyers did it for free. There was Prashant Bhushan who fought the case for free. He said there are people who would, if there's a good enough cause, they will put their energies, they will put their skills. You have to just think through it properly and you have to dedicate yourself towards it. If something's very wrong that is happening, you can do something. And it need not be a very huge thing. Just the right kind of leverage can spell wonders. Myth 5, it is restricted to rich people. Now people think that once I will be rich and then I will be successful and then I will have time and energy and resources to do something. I really haven't found those kind of people. I mean, maybe actually things start somewhere. I mean, in the process, they start doing it. Probably when they are rich and successful, their impact is manifold or magnified. That I agree, because most of these organizations, sometimes even rich people fund them and successful people play important roles. But they start far early, I think. We only see that Mahatma Gandhi, once he was a lawyer and he did this, but he wrote letters of dissent to the English government when he was in college. He started somewhere, like somehow that thing starts building up and up and up, and when you are have certain leverage, you can blow that up into a big, large movement. Again, the second thing is it is restricted to successful people. I would say no. 7, working without money is insane. This is a valid, I will come back to it later, 2 slides later. Working without money is insane. What I have discovered is the more I volunteer, I tend to shift my goals and shift my metrics differently. I tend to think, what is the difference that it brings to the other person? How can I scale this up? How can I do it better in the time I'm putting it? All that stuff is there. The thing that is not there, what do I get in return? What is the monetary value that is giving me? So your perspective shifts, and this is a habit that I have built up over the years. I would not say I used to be like this 4 years back. I used to think a lot, what am I getting? And this thing is not directly helping with my grades or helping with my job. But as I later progressed, I discovered this is a habit or a mindset in itself. How can I increase my impact in whatever work I'm doing? And that starts seeping into your regular work as well. You always, why am I thinking about money? Or why am I thinking about this thing? Let's focus on this, making this thing better first. And that thing is important, but an afterthought. So this is a mindset. I am still not perfect, but this thing constantly was a period where I tussled with, like, why am I putting so much effort into like working for free and making things better? Myth 8, I would lose my wealth. Financially, a little bit, yes. When you are devoting so much time to different things, you could probably do something else and earn a lot more doing else. But the thing is, I have discovered through relationships, the kind of relationships I have developed with other volunteers, and the kind of experiences I have had through those through working, that is far more important, and that gives me a far better happiness and peace of mind. And later on, we always seek vindication from research papers. There's this book by Give and Take by Adam Grant. He's a behavioral economics professor somewhere in the US. And he actually did research and found out people who volunteered a certain number of hours were actually much more happier than people who just worked in their jobs. So, and there's one more thing why I wanted to give this talk. I found there is a very lack of good people who are working there, working out, aligning themselves with their, they want to do something, they don't know what to do, and they don't actually go ahead and do it. And every organization I have worked so far faces a human resource crunch. The people are just not coming in as volunteers or otherwise. So that's a concern. Okay, this is not a myth, a valid concern that you would lose yourself. Lose yourself in the means, I have spent through phases where I have spent questioning my existing assumptions and worldview that, as I told you, working for money versus working for free. Is it okay to like spend this much time in this organization when I know that I have to start afresh on my career again? So I started, I volunteered in multiple places organizing Vipassana courses. Then I have worked in a few places where you serve food. So I have worked in an organization that is on waste segregation called Daily Dump. It's in Bangalore, you might have heard of it. So it sells nice home composting units that you can put right in your balcony. And it would take care of all the biodegradable waste without making any smell. But people don't know about it. So it's a big, huge marketing challenge that I see. Probably one of you can help them out. And I have been working in Aam Aadmi Party for quite a while. I know this is controversial and people have polarizing opinions about it. But I have never seen so many honest people like jumping together on a bandwagon. And honestly, it's not about those leaders, what they are doing on national television. It's about people. For example, the manifestos are made by people like us who are passionate about a particular cause and have expertise to design that manifesto. And actually going out to politicians and say, include this, because this matters. And you can do it with all political parties. If you are passionate about a cause, you are have experience, certain experience, you can go ahead and tell them to include it in their manifestos. They will listen. There are lots of good people in lots of political parties who are willing to listen. So what you can do? So these are something that I could think of. You can think of many more. Join a group who is already passionate about, which is already working on something, and see where you can be a part of it. How can you? Second is commit to a small thing. For example, it can be, let's say I will devote 2 hours per day using my skills to the 2 hours per week for this cause, and you consistently doing it, making a part of your lifestyle. I used to volunteer on and off for the first 1.5 years. Then I started committing my Sundays at a particular organization. That brought a huge difference. I mean, that kind of consistency, knowing that I would go there on a Sunday. And then people start to trust you. You become more responsible in that sphere of, it's again like a job only. You just have to think that, okay, this is like a job. I have to perform well. But this is totally something different. And the last thing would be deliver something so amazing that you can make a business out of it. For example, the Daily Dump thing I was talking about, they created an amazing set of pots that you can actually use for composting. And then try to turn it into a business by selling it. So the business possibility is there as well, but you have to be really, really good in selling that cause. And you have to be really make something useful. And one more thing that I could not find space. Often we go into a particular organization and see things that are done in their way, and we start imposing our opinion because we come from a particular place. I could not put it down. So the thing is, first you have to go ahead whenever you are going and learn for the first few days. Why are they doing things in a certain way? Because they have a lot of valid concerns and a lot of valid challenges they have faced. It's like software. One bug leads to one feature change. So even the design of these organizations is like that. They face some challenge and they designed their organization to face that challenge. Often we don't understand that. Coming from this company structures where we have all this stuff and going to there and the structure is a lot different. It's haphazard. I said, why is it labor intensive? And they tell you, we want volunteers to come in and do this labor intensive work. So this is seva. We are not trying to just, you know, automate this step. And automation would require money. We have more human resources. Some places have more human resources and less money. Some places have more money and no human resources. So you have to understand these challenges. And that's about it. Thank you very much. I would love to take any questions.
Do you have any project that you'd like people to get into?
Actually, lots
while
of
you are thinking, I'll tell you about the Open Defecation Project. It's an international thing.
Okay.
It's download the app onto your Android phone, and if you see people defecating in a particular place, then you want to like press the button so then they can map it. Now, if there are millions of people defecating at that spot, then it can be addressed, as in they'll have a urinal, toilet, or whatever.
Yeah, that's good.
So that's available on the internet.
Okay.
The second thing is the Bangalore Traffic Department. They say take a, I don't know if it's a 200 MB picture of the offending vehicle.
Public
and
eye.
They will.
You can take any kind of picture.
No, yeah. But they are not willing to take heavy pictures.
200 KB.
200 KB.
Oh, 200 KB.
You can put it on the Facebook wall.
Yeah, you can. Either way.
No,
you upload it on the website or
yeah,
put it
on the website. So these are things that.
Okay,
when we leave
can
here,
you repeat that again?
I don't have the website, but it's a Bangalore Police Traffic Department.
BTP, Bangalore Traffic Police app on Android phones. And
so, and it's about pollution or what?
No. The idea is, see, we as activists are standing in front of NK Retail in Indira Nagar, and there are cars parked here, and there's another car parked over here. And when that happens, the auto can go, but the bus cannot go. So every 20 seconds that a bus is idling, BMTC is losing money, and you know, in the big equation, it's not a good thing. So we as volunteers are just making people move people are getting angry, there are confrontations, what have you. The cop says, these people are complaining, that's why I'm giving you the ticket. They don't have the guts to say they're getting a ticket because you're,
parking is
a violation kind of thing. But the fact that we are nobody and we're doing it and it's successful.
One small thing I would like to end it up, time is getting over. One small thing, again, by some person whom I interacted over the, he says, don't pick up a problem that you don't see the solution of. I mean, for example, you are passionate about your children's education. You see that, okay, this is the problem. Go ahead and solve that one problem, solve it really well. For example, if you have the parking problem, go ahead and solve that problem really well. Because once you solve one problem well, that can be publicized. And other people will start, okay, this happened there, I can do it. Most of the time, we require social proof to take massive action. So this is one thing that even while working in those organizations, okay, there's a soft thunderclap used by Five Star Movement in Italy to popularize their party. It was an anti-corruption party. So we had up when we thought, okay, this guy used thunderclap, why don't we use similar software? Like, it basically it says, once you connect your Facebook and Twitter, it sends out the same status message at a particular time. So once you have 10,000 people putting up the same status, the thing automatically trends to get notice of
nice.
People. Nice. So even we thought that, oh my God, thunderclap did some nice work. We should try to emulate it. So the thing is, focus on one problem, focus on it really well. And as that thing gets popular, it will automatically benefit a lot of people out there. So often we think we are small. What I can do about the whole world? You don't need to. Just focus on making your life better. And even volunteering is not something you go out and help people. You are making your life better, more peaceful, more happy. Thank you.